Today we'll discuss how to interpret the results of a simple regression analysis using the Excel data analysis tools. Hi, this is Mike Nigami, Lean Sigma Black Belt. We learned about the basics of regression analysis and how to get a single regression equation from the scatter plot in the previous video. If you would like to review the basics of regression analysis once again, please take a look at the video from the link above. Here are the results from the previous scatter plot. We obtained a simple regression equation of y equals 0.4738x plus 35.519 and a coefficient of determination of 0.9727. In practice, you can complete your job with only the scatter plot many times, but performing a single regression analysis will give you more significant information. Let's see the result of a simple regression analysis in Excel with the same data first. There are so many numbers, but you really only need to know the parts in yellow for business at least. The numbers in a coefficient column are the exact same numbers as the coefficient and intercept in the regression equation. Therefore, you'll use these numbers to make a regression equation. Next is the p-value of the x-value. It's difficult to see, so change it to a percentage. It's 0.00015%. This p-value is a numerical value which we cannot get from the scatter plot. Simply speaking, you can see how well your explanatory variable explains the objective variable. In a multiple regression analysis, this p-value is very important, and you can find which explanatory variable among the others has the most influence on the objective variable. For a little more detail, the p-value is the probability of a null hypothesis. What is that? The null hypothesis in regression analysis is to assume that the explanatory variable of this x is no relation to the objective variable of y. Generally, if this percentage is less than 5%, this null hypothesis can be rejected. In other words, being no relation is rejected, which means that there is a lot of relationship between x and y. In our case, the probability is 0.00015%, which is much less than 5%, so we reject it, which means their relationship is significant. If this p-value is more than 5%, you need to check the data for errors and add more sample data to reduce the analysis, or conclude that the two data groups have no relation. In our case, it's less than 5%, so I can continue to the next step. Let's look at the top table, see R square. This number is exactly the same as the coefficient of determination in the scatter plot. This is between 0 to 1 and indicates how well the regression equation calculates the objective variable. Closer to 1 is better. Multiple R is the correlation coefficient. You know that squaring it will be the same as the R square. However, I would like you to use the adjusted R square below as a coefficient of determination. It's little lower than the R square above. What's the difference between the two? In practice, you may need to add more explanatory variables and perform the multiple regression analysis. The R square above has the characteristic that the more you have explanatory variables, the higher the number becomes, which is misleading. The adjusted R square below corrects that issue. There is not much influence by it in a simple regression analysis, but it would be better to use the adjusted R square regularly. Lastly, I'll briefly show how to get simple regression analysis results from the Excel data analysis tools. Click Data, Data Analysis Tools, and select Regression. In Input Y Range, you'll select the data of your objective variable, in my case, video duration. In the Input X Range, you'll select the data of your explanatory variable, in my case, its number of blog words, and OK. If you don't see Data Analysis Tools in the Data ribbon, click File, Options, and Add-in. After making sure that there is Excel Add-in here, click Go. Check Analysis Toolpak and click OK. Then it will show up. You can conduct scatter plot and simple regression analysis with Excel very easily, so please put some data in and practice them. Then you'll find unexpected discoveries in your business. Thank you very much for viewing. Please click the subscribe button. Also, click and watch my other related videos. Thanks.